Turning now to the coronavirus crisis back home with our team out across the country. The New South Wales Homicide Squad will probe the Ruby Princess disaster with confirmation four more passengers have died. Straight to today's Sydney reporter Gabrielle Boyle. Gabby, what will investigators be looking for?
Yeah, good morning, Alex. This is now being treated as a fully-fledged criminal investigation. It's being headed up by New South Wales homicide detectives. These are the same types of detectives that you see investigating a murder and manslaughter here in New South Wales, an indication of just how seriously this situation is being taken. They'll take a very close look at exactly what happened on board the Ruby Princess in the days and hours leading up to those 2,700-odd passengers disembarking at the overseas passenger terminal, exactly what they knew about their health and what was communicated to those people on shore. Of course, we've now had 600 people from on board the Ruby Princess test positive. And tragically, over the weekend, as you said there, another four have lost their lives. It brings to a total of 11 people from on board the Ruby Princess who've fallen victim to COVID-19. Brad Hazzard, the New South Wales Health Minister, he has again reiterated over the weekend that he does not take responsibility for those passengers getting off that cruise ship. No doubt New South Wales Police will be having a very close look at every aspect of exactly why this debacle happened.
What a mess. Gabby Boyle, thank you.
Sure is. A big week in Canberra as the government works to pass its $130 billion JobKeeper scheme in the coming days. Political reporter Fiona Willen has more from Canberra. V, there has been some changes.
Yeah, that's right, Carl. Look, more charity workers will now be able to receive these payments. We know the government is considering ways to include more casuals too. So as it stands, these $1,500 per fortnight JobKeeper payments, they'll be available to full-time and part-time workers, as well as casuals who have been with one employer for at least a year. But the government is in talks with unions about how to expand this to more people, particularly to casuals who have had more than one employer in a year. Unions are also pushing for a change to that one-year rule. So if these changes go ahead, around 1.1 million extra workers would be eligible for these payments. Overnight, the government changed the rules for charity workers, so not-for-profits are now eligible if they can demonstrate a loss of 15%. The government's aiming to put the finishing touches on this bill today before a vote in Parliament on Wednesday, Carl.
Thank you, Fee.
Well, it's the news no student wants to hear. They could possibly be forced to repeat the current school year. Let's go to Today Melbourne reporter Christine Ahern. And Chris, this is obviously the worst case scenario. What do students and parents need to know?
Well, Ali, a year 13 is the worst possible outcome, but everyone feels for year 12 students at the moment with all this disruption. And to try and counter it, the Victorian Premier Daniel Andrews last night said that VCE students here could possibly study for an extra 6 to 8 weeks at the end of the year, in essence, playing catch up. That could mean the year could spill into next, into 2021. That would then have a knock-on effect to universities and TAFEs. The state government says they're currently working through those issues. But here is the Premier last night.
Our aim is to get an ATAR, get Year 12 done, whether it be this calendar year or just maybe spilling into the early part of next year. But it's stressful, I know.
As for term two, as to whether students are going to be in school or continue to study remotely, the Premier says he'll be finalising that in the coming days. Ali.
OK, thanks, Chris.
Police are ramping up patrols to catch those who continue to flout social distancing rules ahead of the Easter long weekend. Today, Queensland reporter Jessica Millward is on the Gold Coast. Jess, this could include closing down beaches there.
That's right, Alex. At the moment, we're allowed to exercise on the beach, go for a swim or go for a walk. But as the saying goes, this is why we can't have nice things, because plenty of people have been flouting those rules over the weekend, congregating on the beach, sunbaking and completely ignoring social distancing restrictions. The Premier had already warned we were on our last warning, so we may see her take action today and close beaches, and that's exactly what happened at Manly Beach yesterday. If people don't comply, they will be fined. That's what happened to plenty of people on the weekend that thought it would be a good idea to gather at a car rally and do burnouts there. They were drinking. Police charged some 58 of them. They've described it as completely inexcusable and putting the lives of Queenslanders at risk. So the very stern message from authorities right across the country is to not travel unnecessarily this Easter long weekend or you will be fined. But kids, I have some good news. there is someone that is exempt from that, and that is the Easter Bunny. So the eggs will be coming.
Thank God. Jess Millwood, thank you.